Over 600 athletes comprise the University of Delaware athletic program. What happens after those 4 years are over varies for many. But two former standout athletes are leading their teams from a different position, the sideline. On the volleyball court, Kim Stewart led her team to 4 conference titles and 3 NCAA appearances. Now Kim enters her first year of coaching alongside head coach Bonnie Kenny. John Scheer, one of Coach Ian Hennessy's first recruits for the Blue Hens soccer program, proved to be a leader on the field as a 3-year starter and senior captain. 2012 will be John's second season as assistant coach. The journey that led to where John and Kim are today started with their decision to commit to Delaware and follow through with their careers on the court and field.
As soon as I stepped on campus, I knew exactly that I wanted to come here. Meeting the team, meeting the coaches, walking around campus, you just get a good feel of, like, this is home again. Like, this is my home away from home. Our team is definitely like my second family now.
Ian, for me, was a very honest guy, and he still is, and that's what kind of made me gravitate towards him, is that he was, you know, you could tell that he's very genuine and very competitive, and he wants to win, he wants to push the program forward. So for me, the campus academics is great here, and the soccer was all a plus for me.
For John, he always knew his life on the field would someday lead to coaching, and he attributes his current role to head coach Ian Hennessy, who not only saw something in him as a player, but also as a coach.
When Ian offered it to me, I sat down with my family and I realized that, you know, I was happy with my career as a soccer player, and I couldn't pass up the career in coaching.
I can't tell you, I can't stress enough how important having people that have grown up in the program that understand, you know, what I'm looking for, even when I'm not looking or giving them instruction. So he has been a huge influence, a positive influence on this program as a player, as a captain, and now as an assistant coach, and I think his better years are ahead for that young man.
After Kim's 4 years as a player were up, she knew there was more for her to experience within Delaware volleyball.
After graduating last year, I knew that I wanted to stay around this program, and I actually have the opportunity to do so within my last semester, being able to come on staff and be part of the coaching staff here at Delaware.
What makes John and Kim an asset on the coaching staff is their relationship with their respective teams. With John 2 years removed and Kim a mere 11 months, these former student athletes continue to have strong bonds with the players they once shared a locker room with.
I can relate to them in the sense that I've been here and I've played for Delaware, I've played under Ian, so I know what he's like and I know what he likes and what he doesn't like, so I can connect to them on that level. But at the end of the day, that they want to win and I want to win, so it doesn't matter if I played with them, it doesn't matter if I didn't.
I understand what they're going through because I just did it. I understand how hard it is to wake up at 6:30 to go lift weights at 7. I understand that you don't want to run the 300s, but you need to in order to become that much better.
Kim is obviously an extension of our staff and somebody that our team can look at as, especially the kids that have been here that have played with her and know that she's somebody that did everything for us, a 6 rotation player. So she brings that presence in practice when we need her to play and also from the bench.
2011 proved to be one of the most remarkable seasons for the Blue Hens soccer program, entering their first conference championship and making their first NCAA tournament appearance. But John's contribution towards the Hens' success goes beyond his role as an assistant coach.
To see that transformation from my freshman and sophomore till when I became a junior and a senior, when we started winning some more games, not as many as we did last year, I think it was great because it was that group, but it was a lot of things happening before that as well. Just to see how far Delaware has come as a soccer program is really rewarding.
As a player, Kim was a huge part of the Hens' 4 conference titles and 3 NCAA appearances. Now she looks to help her team find more success from a new spot on the floor.
We have this huge target on our back because we've won the conference championship 4 out of the last 5 years. I think it just gives us a better opportunity to grow as a program and also as this group of girls.
John and Kim are two former athletes that have influenced their teams in more ways than one. Whether on the court and field as a player, or on the sidelines, their new role has not only influenced their perspective on the game, but also what it takes to be a good coach.
I don't think you necessarily have to be the best player to be a good coach, but I think you have to see the game well. I think you have to be competitive, you have to want to win, and you have to be able to be a good educator and a good teacher.
They're maybe not the best player on the team, but they may bring the most energy to the team. They want to learn everything that coach is able to teach them, and that's what I think would make a good player become a good coach.
For Blue Hens Beat, I'm Kara Pokropski.